This video is going to be about solving equations in more than one step. And this time I want to do equations that have fractions in them. So let's take a look at the first one. Okay, so here I've got 2x minus 3 halves equals 3 minus x, and I've got this fraction here. Now, a lot of people don't like fractions, but once you understand them and practice them enough, they're not that hard. So let's get some practice with this one. Since I've got this one fraction, what I'm going to do is make everything into a fraction. In other words, I'm going to use 1 as a denominator for each one of these terms, because you can take any whole number or anything and place it over a 1 and it doesn't change anything. So now that I've got all these fractions, I want a common denominator. Well, the common denominator is 2. Remember, a common denominator is a number that I can turn all of the denominators into by doing some multiplication. And obviously I can turn all the 1s into 2s by multiplying by 2. Now what I'm going to do, because I've got an equation, and this only works for equations, is I'm going to multiply everything here, every one of these terms, by the common denominator. So that means I'm going to take this first fraction and multiply it by 2. Take the second fraction and multiply it by 2, and so on. So let's see what happens. 2 times 2x is going to be 4x over 1, but I don't need the 1. I've got a negative sign. 2 times 3 halves means that I can cancel out, I can factor out these 2s, and I'll just get a minus 3. 2 times 3 over 1 is going to be 6 over 1, but I don't need the 1 anymore. And minus 2 times x over 1 will be 2x over 1. Once again, I don't need the 1. Now I've gotten rid of all my fractions. Okay, so now we're back to the kind of problems you're used to. So what I'm going to do is, let's see, I'll add 3 to both sides. I want to isolate the x. And I'm going to get 4x equals 9 minus 2x. I still have an x over here, so I'll add 2x to both sides. That's going to give me 6x equals 9. And now all I have to do is divide both sides by 6. So I've got x equals 9 over 6. And of course, I can reduce 9 over 6. Both of these numbers can be divided by 3. So 9 divided by 3 is 3. 6 divided by 3 is 2. So my answer is going to be x equals 3 halves. So just to review this for a second, what I did was I took every term in my equation and I gave it a denominator. The denominator I gave it, if it didn't have one, was a 1. Then I multiplied everything by my common denominator. When you do that, you're going to get rid of all the denominators, which is what I have here. And now you're just solving this the way you've solved other equations. Let's look at another one. So this one, we're starting out with two fractions. X over 2 minus x over 4 equals negative 2. But I want to give everything, I want to make everything be a fraction. So I'm going to give this a denominator of 1. Now I need my common denominator, and it's going to be my biggest number here, since I can turn a 2 into a 4 by multiplying, and I can turn a 1 into a 4 by multiplying. So that means I'm going to take every term here and multiply it by the common denominator. So everything gets multiplied by 4. Well, the first one, I've got 4x over 2, and I can simplify that by dividing the numerator and the denominator by 2, so I'll get 2x. I've got my minus sign. Then I've got 4 times x over 4, that's going to be 4x over 4, but the 4s will cancel, so I'll just get an x. Then I've got a negative 4 over 2 halves, well, 4 times 2 is 8. I'm sorry, 4 times 2 over 1, 4 times 2 is 8, and I don't need the 1 anymore. So now I've got something really simple. I'm going to combine these two terms over here, the 2x and the negative x. That'll just give me an x, and x will equal negative 8. So once again, what I did was I made sure that everything had a denominator, found the common denominator, which was 4, multiplied everything by that common denominator. That got rid of all my denominators all at once. Now I've got no more fractions, and I can go ahead and finish solving it. And as with the other problems, you can check these. I'm not going to bother right now, but you can check this by substituting negative 8 into for each one of these x's. Okay, here's one more. So I've got x over 2 equals 5/3. Now, I could find a common denominator, which would be 6, and multiply both of these fractions by 6. But when you've got only two fractions, you've got an equation, and both sides are fractions, then you can cross-multiply. A lot of students cross-multiply anytime they see two fractions. To cross-multiply, you've got to have an equation, first of all, and both sides have to be fractions. If that's the case, you can multiply the numerator on the left side by the denominator on the right side. So I'm going to multiply these two, and that will give me 3x. And you can multiply the denominator on the left by the numerator on the right. So I'm going to multiply 2 times 5, and that will give me a 10. And now I just want to isolate this x, so I'll divide both sides by 3. And that will give me x equals 10/3. Okay, so remember, if you want to cross multiply, first of all, make sure you've got an equation. And second of all, make sure that you've got a fraction on each side of the equation and nothing else. Just two fractions, one on each side of the equation. And that's it. So I hope this has helped you. Practice your fractions. I'll see you next time.